we're around the paddock with Andy Ayres here. Now, Andy, we're at the races, we're stood in the paddock, the horses are walking round. What are we looking for?
Okay, Matt, I think the first thing to look for is the horse's well-being.
Right.
Okay, general well-being. So for that, we want to look at the horse's coat. It's the easiest way of working.
What about this one here?
This horse here, he looks well in his coat, doesn't he? Look, he's got a nice, shiny, bright coat. No pimples or blemishes on him. He looks well. That's kind of what we're looking for. That type of horse, as opposed to one that looks dry and dull in his coat, which is a sign that they're not really at a peak and they want a bit more time.
Okay, what else are we looking for? If we look at the
temperament, Matt, I think temperament's something that's important. You don't want to see a horse walking around sweating or grinding its teeth or looking nervous, because obviously it's a sign of stress, and they'll be running a race before the race, if you know what I mean. So one horse walking around, ears pricked. Horse there looks a bit dull in its coat, you see, the nine horse.
So when you say dull in its coat,
there's no shine on his coat, is there? He looks dull, doesn't he? He looks like he's just a little bit backward, you know, a little bit behind. Whereas the horse we saw earlier looked really nice and bright.
So compared to the one we've got round here, the eight, looks much better in its coat.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. It does to me, doesn't it to you?
Yeah, it does, yeah.
So it's common sense, really, isn't it? It's nothing really too complicated, really. I think it's overcomplicated often, to be honest. So yeah, but temperament wise you just want to see a horse walking around with its ears nice and pricked, taking an interest in what's going on around it, but not being worried. That's the key, really.
So basically, I guess it's sometimes like us, where we can wake up in the morning, we look in the mirror and you think, oh, my skin doesn't, you know, when you're eating right, your skin looks better. And it's
right.
The same with horses.
Absolutely right. I honestly think people overcomplicate it, and generally it's just common sense, really. Fitness is the third thing, of course, and that's the hardest thing to gauge, because they're all different makes and shapes and sizes, aren't they, and body types. So that's much more difficult to work out. But generally, you want a horse with a nice, big, well-muscled back end, because that's their engine. That's where they do all the work. That's the power.
And what about this seven here? This looks to me like it probably need a bit more time.
Exactly, and the horse behind him looks the opposite, doesn't he? He looks really fit, the three. The three horse looks really revved up. Looks like he's going down early. So he's probably quite a keen type of horse, and a keen type of horse would tend to get itself fit anyway, you know.
So why would a horse go down early compared to the other with staying longer?
Because his horse probably pulls a bit hard in company, so if there's other horses going down with him, it will rev him up and he'll pull too hard, so he'll go down on his own nice and quietly, perhaps even walk down before the other jockeys have got on. So yeah, it's just a way of, you know, keeping the horse nice and calm, keeping the lid on him, so that when, you know, the stall's open, he's got plenty of gas in the tank, as we say, that he's whipped around.
Yeah. But, so it's a negative, though, isn't it?
Yeah, negative. And all the signs of, like, sweating, grinding their teeth, all of those things are negatives. You know, all signs of stress and tension, which obviously you don't want to see.
So if there's an Andy Ayres top three things to look at around the paddock, what are they?
It would be a horse to be nice and relaxed in the prelims, to look nice and fit in terms of, as I say, well muscled up behind the saddle, and to go down nice and collected. I think it's really important to watch horses go to post. I say it's almost the most important thing for me, because if they don't act on the ground, they can't win the race, you know. The ground plays a massive, massive factor. So if you've got a horse with a light skimming action, it want quick ground like we've got today. If you've got a horse with a big poundy action, he'll want softer ground. So it's really important to watch the horses go to post. I think that's probably one of the most important factors for me personally.
Right, now what we're going to do here is, because you're sponsoring this race around the paddock with Andy Ayres, we've got to look at for the best turned out. Now,
okay. This
is, I guess, slightly something a little bit different, where I guess you're looking to see...
Well, it's not like with the best turned out, it wouldn't be looking at the best looking horse. It's a horse where the groom's done the most work, really, for me. And say you take this horse here, you know, she's bothered to plait the horse's mane, so he looks really nice. If you can find one that would plait the mane and the tail, it'd be even better. Let's give it to the 10, because we said the 10 had a nice...
Okay, so the 10. So why are you giving best turned out to the 10?
Because she's plaited the horse's mane, hasn't she? The horse looks really well in itself. I think she's probably put a lot of effort in getting the horse ready for the race. So, yeah, I'd say it's... looks really well.
And it's a big deal for these stable staff, isn't it? Coming here, there's a £50 has been given by Valuerator for these today.
Tremendously hard, and yeah, they don't get the recognition they deserve, really.